Hello and welcome to this episode of Denny's Tips. This week, I updated one of my best-selling products, Double Exposure Kit. This product was created in 2015, but it's still being used by a lot of people, so I released another update for it, which includes more textures and blending modes. This product lets you create awesome-looking double exposure photos in a short amount of time. There's a free version that will let you create basic double exposures, and if you want to get more creative, the pro version will give you way more Photoshop actions, textures, and gradients. In the third version of this product, you get new blending modes such as Difference Mask, Exclusion, Exclusion Mask, Radial Gradient, and Reflected Gradient. There are also other tweaks, such as a stronger fade layer, so you can control how much fade to increase or decrease simply by changing the layer opacity. Let me show you how to use these Photoshop actions. Start by creating a document with two layers, one of your foreground and background image. To do this, I'll start off by opening a texture as the background. Then I'll drag and drop a foreground image into Photoshop, which will place it as a new layer. There's no rule to what type of photo you can or cannot use, but generally people like to use a high contrast silhouette like this one, and combine it with a texture like this one. If you don't already have the actions loaded, simply double click on the ATM file and it'll show up in your actions panel. Make sure that you're loading the right ATM file. There's three ATM files, depending if you're using Photoshop Elements, Photoshop CS3 to CS6, or Photoshop CC. The Photoshop CC edition has some special features, such as error detection, which can automatically fix common document issues. Aside from that, the Photoshop CS3 to CS6 runs pretty much the same. You'll be able to find the actions in the Actions panel. If you don't see this, you can open it by going to Window, Actions. If you're using Photoshop CS3 to CS6, you'll need to play the first action here, which will unlock your background layer in case it is locked. With Photoshop CC, it'll do this automatically. Next, select the Play All Effects action and let it run. The action will play all 20 of the actions, which saves you a lot of time compared to playing them one by one. If you're using Photoshop Elements, unfortunately you don't have access to this action, but you do have every single effect here, and you can play the actions individually. When it's done playing, go to History panel and pick an effect. The effect will show up immediately because they're all pre-rendered. This is a feature that I like to implement in a lot of my products because it saves you a lot of time. There are many ways to create double exposures, and now you can experiment with a bunch of techniques just by playing one single action. By the way, all of the effects have fully editable and non-destructive layers, so you can go in and edit the layers all you want. You can adjust the opacity of the fade layer, which gives your photo the faded film look. The contrast enhancement layer can be turned on or off to increase the contrast of your foreground layer. Finally, there's a gradient overlay layer, which you can use to add a gradient. A lot of times, you'll find that the gradients work very well with double exposures. This product includes a bunch of pre-made gradients that work great with double exposures. You can load it simply by double-clicking on the GRD file. Once the gradients are loaded, you can edit the gradient layer and pick any gradient you like. If you want to experiment with other textures, simply drag and drop the image into your document and move it to the bottom of your layer stack. I usually like to load at least a couple textures to experiment and see which one looks the best. This will work with every blending mode except for auto blend and the new masked effects. For those, you need to play the actions again. And just like that, we now have a pretty cool looking double exposure photo with fully editable layers. Here are some examples created with this product. Double exposures are really fun effects to create, and these actions let you experiment with a lot of different techniques in a short amount of time. Try them out and let me know what you think. You can find the download link in the video description below. There's a free version if you just want to do basic double exposures. If you want to get more creative, you can upgrade to the pro version. And if you do, thank you so much for your support. Your contributions help support me and my channel so I can continue creating add-ons and tutorials for you and everyone. So I want to thank you so much for that. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I hope you like these Photoshop actions. If you need any help or if you have any questions, there's an HTML file in the download, and in there you can find out where to contact me. Aside from that, I wish you an awesome day. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll see you again next week.